Hi students, today our study is about operations research. What is operations research? We have to discuss what is operations research. Actually, operations research is a management optimization technique. Actually, it is used in the military campuses because without fighting, how you can win a war? That is the base of operations research. Then this operation research is transferred to different areas in the field of business, industry, different projects, etc., etc. There are different various use. In the field of strategic management also, we are using this operations research. In the field of engineering, in the field of research, in the field of different project constructions like dam construction, different new aircraft manufacturing, new shipbuilding, etc., we are using these operation research techniques. There are various areas in these operation research techniques. Today we are discussing about one such technique, that is transportation technique. So now we are starting this transportation technique. Actually, the concept of transportation technique is that a management, that is a company, a manufacturing unit, whatever may be, they are transporting various units of homogeneous commodity from certain origins, that is certain plants, to certain destination points. Destination points can be warehouse, it can be a selling unit. We are transporting goods by minimizing the transportation charges according to destination points demand and according to origins supply capacity. We are transporting goods. Actually, there are three methods for transporting goods from one origin to different destinations. One origin in the sense, there are certain factories for this manufacturer. Suppose in one area, one manufacturer has four plants and he has got different destination in different states. Suppose like that. We are supplying goods from different plants, that is factories of one manufacturer, not one factory. The concept of transportation cost is that there are different factories. All these factories are producing homogeneous products, that is not different products, a single product. This single product from different factories are transporting to four or five destination. This is the concept of transportation technique. Here we are applying three methods for solving this transportation technique. I will write all the three methods here. First of all, we can discuss northwest corner rule. First of all, I will discuss about the transportation matrix. This is a transportation matrix, and we have to write this matrix in columnar form. Okay, here destination. This destination already I told you that this destination can be warehouse or selling unit A, B, C, D. Then these are the plant. There are three plants: plant 1, plant 2, plant 3. Here we can write supply. This supply units is related to all the three plants. That is, supply, according to supply capacity of these plants, we are writing commodity, homogeneous commodity in units. This transportation problem is in a matrix form like this. There are different columns, different rows. Okay. Row wise, usually we are writing plant. That is, from these plants, we are transporting goods to destinations. These destinations can be, actually I am writing it as D1, D2, D3. These destinations can be warehouse or selling units, whatever may be, markets, whatever may be. Plant P1, P2, P3, P4. Here, demand or requirement, whatever may be. Here, supply, that is availability of these plants. Here we are writing the demand quantity of these destinations. These are the demand quantity of these three destinations. And here, actually, these are the demand units. According to the demand of these destination units and according to supply capacity of these plants, we are transporting homogeneous products to these destinations. Okay, inside given, see, inside given are transportation charges. Our transportation charges. These are the transportation charges. Here the concept is, if we are transporting goods from plant 1 to destination 2, the transportation charge is 7. Okay, plant 1 has got capacity 5 units and destination 2 has got 9 units demand. So let us start northwest corner road. See, this is the north part, this is the west part. Okay, then we are starting our allocation. Actually, transportation technique is an allocation technique. We are allocating homogeneous products from these plants to these destinations. According to northwest corner rule, this is the first point. This is the first point. Because we are starting, we are allocating goods from plants to destination from here. Because in the this matrix, in this square matrix, this is the northwest part. So this method is called northwest corner rule. So see, this plant can supply 5 units and this destination point can demand, its demand is 7 units. So we can transport only 5 units because from plant 1 we are transporting goods to the destination 1. Its demand is only 7 units, so you can transport only 5 units. Okay, 5. Then if you are writing 5 here, then cut this because plant 1 out. Here the demand 2 units, remaining 2 units. This destination point can take these 2 units from these plants. We can solve this problem in one matrix or you can prepare other matrix for this preparation. Let us start second matrix. That is, we can use this matrix for doing full problem or to avoid confusion, we can write the second step. See the second step like this. You have to, before starting this problem, we have to add all these supply units and all these demand units. Demand must be equal to supply. Here, demand total is equal to the supply total. That is the importance of transportation problem. Otherwise, this transportation problem can be considered as an unbalanced transportation problem. Here, this problem is a balanced problem. So, we can start second step. Then, here, northwest corner road. Here we are writing only two units. Why? Here, this demand is only two units. And this P2 factory can, P2 plant can supply 8 units. So, suppose we are writing 2, then here 6. Why? 2 units I taken to destination 1. Then destination 1's program over. Completely satisfied. Then, third step, that is 3, 1, 4, 7, 6, 2. D3, then P2, P3, P4. 6, 7, 14. See, this is equal. 9, 18, 27. Total, 27. Demand total and supply total, both 27. Again, this corner. That is northwest corner rule. See, this plant can supply only 6 units. Its supply capacity 6 units. Its demand 9 units. We can provide only 6 units. Then plant 2 over. Remaining 3. Then next step. Total 21. Demand and supply total always equal. Then this corner here, this destination 2 demand is only 3 units, here supply 7 units, whichever less, because they need only 3 units. We have to provide only 3 units, not more than that. Then 3 units, then gone 4 units. Then no need to use northwest corner rule, only 2 rows, 4, 14, 18. Then no need to use northwest corner rule, only 2 rows. So put 4 here, put 14 here. That is 4 plus 14, 18, here also 18. Our allocation complete. This is the northwest corner. It's a step-by-step procedure. Okay. Then we have to find out the total transportation charges. Actually, total transportation charges in the sense, units into amount. That is, these are all transportation charge cost. Transportation charges, transportation cost. Then, what, see this allocation 5, that is unit allocation 5, amount is 2 rupees, that is 2 rupees for transporting 5 units of commodity. You multiply it. See, 5 into 2 plus here 2 into 3 plus here 6 into 3, then here 3 into 4 plus 4 into 7 plus 14 into 2. Okay, this is the final answer. You multiply this and add. That's the final answer for this northwest corner rule. Therefore, the total transportation cost is ₹102. This is northwest corner rule. let us discuss the next method, lowest cost entry method. The same problem. We are discussing the same problem. There are three methods. Generally, there are three methods. One is northwest corner rule. This one. Next one is lowest cost entry. The third one is Vogel's approximation method. But answer different. We are following this northwest corner rule. Here the answer is 102 rupees. Then now let us start lowest cost entry method. See the difference in answer. Let us continue lowest cost entry method. In northwest corner rule, we are starting from this. Why? This is the northwest part. After different metric step, we are using this corner. Here, we are starting our allocation from the cell where there is lowest value, lowest cost. Here, rupee 1, here rupee 1, lowest cost. You can start your allocation from anywhere. Okay, from here or from here. Let us start from here. Okay, then here from P2, from P2 to D3. 8 units P2 can supply, 18 units D3 demands. So, we can transport only 8 units. After putting 8, then P2 over here, 10 units remaining. Then our next step. Then next lowest here is 1. So, we are putting 7 because its demand is only 7 units and P4 can supply 14 units. No need of 14 units. We are supplying only 7 units because of its demand. So, D1's demand over, then remaining 7. Then, next step. Here the lowest value is 2. So, allocation here. P4 can supply 7 units and D3 demand 10 units. We can transport only 7 units because supply units less. So cut this P4 and 3 units remaining. Okay, then next step. Again, smallest value, that is 4. 4 is the smallest value. In both cells, there is 4. Anywhere. So, I am taking this 4. Okay. That is 7 units. Here, 9 units demand. Can't satisfy the demand. 7 units. So, cut this P3. Again, here 2. Then, the last step. No need to follow this lowest cost entry method. Only 2 columns. Here 2 columns. Here 5. Here 2. 3. D2, D3. So only P1. Then you can put 2 here. You can put 3 here. Total 5, 2 and 3. So this is the lowest cost entry method. That is, here we are following the cell where there is lowest cost. Allocate first there, then continue in that in other steps. So here the total transportation cost is 8 into 1 plus 7 into 1 plus 7 into 2 plus 7 into 4 plus 2 into 7 plus 3 into 4. Here the total transportation cost is Rs. 83. See the difference? In the case of Northwest Corner Road, the total charges is 102. But in this case, in this method, lowest cost entry method, it's only 83. That is the difference. One more method we have to study, that is Vogel's approximation method. Then the third method is Vogel's approximation method. This is the most reliable method among the three methods: Northwest Corner Rule, Lowest Cost Entry, and Vogel's approximation. Among these three, this is the most reliable method. We have to study optimality test. In from all these methods, we get only a basic feasible solution, not an optimal solution. Optimal solution is the best solution. See, different solutions we get. According to Northwest Corner Rule, the total transportation cost is 102. Lowest cost entry method, the total cost is 83. Then, this is the most reliable method. We are using base for optimality test, this Vogel's approximation method. We are doing a penalty test here. Okay, the same problem. Then you can compare the transportation charges. Northwest Corner Road, we are touching here. Then lowest cost entry, we are allocating in the place where there is lowest cost. But in Vogel's approximation method, we are using a penalty method. Penalty, that is, let us discuss about penalty calculation. See, here the lowest value in each row and in each column, we are considering the lowest cost and second lowest cost. The difference between these two considered as penalty, and that penalty value you can write here in brackets after this supply units, here below this demand unit. So let us start. Here the lowest in this row, first consider row. In this row, 2 is the lowest value and 4 is the highest value, second lowest value. The difference 2. Write that 2 here. Then it is considered as penalty. Here 1 and 3. 2. Here 5 and 4. 1. Here 1 and 2. 1. Here 1 and 2. 1. Here 3 and 4. 1. Here 1 and 2. 1. Then you can start your allocation where there is consider the highest penalty. Here all 1, here 2, here 2. We can allocate in the place in the row or in the column where you can find highest penalty. Here 2, here 2. These two are highest penalty rows. But you can select this row. Why? Here minimum cost. If you are selecting this row, the minimum cost is 2. If you select this row, the minimum cost is 1. So better start allocation here. Okay, then here. Say it 18, 8 you can put, because supply units lower than demand. So cut this, the remaining 10. Then Next step. Okay, again start penalty. Then 2 and 4, 2 again, 5 and 4, 1, here also 1, here also 1, here 2. Okay, here 2, 2 and 4, 2. There are 3 places you can find highest penalty. Suppose you choose this row, you can allocate here 2. This row you can allocate in this place. Suppose you are choosing this, you can choose here. Anywhere you can put your allocation. See, I am choosing this. Okay, then here it is 5, so supply only 5 units, demand 7 units. We can allocate only 5 units, P1 out. Then here remaining 2 units. Then third step. Again penalty. 5 and 4, 1, 1, this is 4, this is 2, this is 5. So highest penalty belongs to D3 column. So here you put one arrow, then here you can allocate in this place because lowest cost here. Then you can allocate 10 units because D3's demand only 10 units. Okay, cut this D3, then remaining 4. Okay, next step. Again penalty. 5 and 4, 1, 1 and 6, 5, 5 and 1, 4, 4 and 6, 2. Here the highest penalty. So we must allocate in this row. Here the lowest value is 1. So put allocation there. 2 and 4. You can allocate 2 only because D1's demand only 2 units, not more than that we can pass. So cut D1. Then the last step, no need to put penalty. There are only 2 rows. Here 2, it is 7, 2, here 9, only D2, P3 and P4. Allocate 7 here, allocate 2 here. It is complete. Then let us find out the total transportation cost. That is 8 into 1 plus 5 into 2 plus 10 into 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 7 into 4 plus 2 into 6. Here the total transportation cost is rupees 80. See the difference. Here it is 80. In the case of lowest cost entry method, it is 83. And in the case of northwest corner rule, it is 102. I am telling you, Vogel's approximation method is the most reliable method. This method is used as a base for doing optimality test. This is considered as the reliable method because we get minimum transportation cost here compared to the other two methods. So the 3 methods relating to transportation problem over, these are the 3 methods. And the next class I will discuss about optimality test. That is, while using these 3 methods, we get only initial basic feasible solution. If you are doing optimality test, we get optimal solution. That is the best reliable solution. For doing that optimality test, the base Vogel's approximation method, because it is the reliable method. So today I am concluding my class. The next day, let us start with the optimality test. I am believing that you all like my class. Please put comments, your expert comments about my class. Your comments are very important for me. Okay, thank you.